Orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst was first described as an orthokeratinizing variant of odontogenic keratocyst in 1981. The basis of this distinction was the difference in its histopathology and its reduced chances of recurrence as compared to odontogenic keratocyst, although it was not given the status of a distinct odontogenic cyst. Later in 2005, odontogenic keratocyst was classified as a tumor considering its aggressive behavior and growth potential, and was renamed keratocystic odontogenic tumor. However, orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst was not considered to be a part of the tumor spectrum of keratocystic odontogenic tumor. It is now known and accepted that orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst is a distinct clinicopathologic entity on its own. In fact, it has been listed as a developmental odontogenic cyst in the recent World Health Organization classification of odontogenic cysts. Also, the WHO consensus group has removed keratocystic odontogenic tumor from the odontogenic tumor category and has reclassified it as an odontogenic cyst. So why is orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst considered to be a distinct odontogenic cyst and not just a variant of odontogenic keratocyst? Well, orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst may resemble odontogenic keratocyst clinically and histologically, but there are quite a few differences that make orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst stand out. Well, for starters, orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst is not clinically aggressive and has a low rate of recurrence, as low as 4%. This is in contrast to odontogenic keratocyst, which shows destructive behavior and has a high rate of recurrence. In fact, reports indicate odontogenic keratocysts to have an average recurrence rate of 28 to 30%. Another distinction between the two cysts is the non-association of orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst with nevoid basal cell carcinoma syndrome, otherwise called Gorlin syndrome. At least 90% of the patients with Gorlin syndrome manifest with multiple odontogenic keratocysts. However, there have not been records of any association of orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst with Gorlin syndrome. Most odontogenic keratocyst patients are asymptomatic and show no swelling of the jaws. Well, this is attributed to the anteroposterior growth pattern of odontogenic keratocyst as opposed to a buccolingual expansion. Orthokeratinized odontogenic cysts, on the other hand, are significantly associated with swelling of jaws as compared to odontogenic keratocysts. Almost 2/3, or at least 68% of orthokeratinized odontogenic cysts are associated with an unerupted tooth, mimicking a dentigerous cyst on the radiograph. It is reported that only 25 to 40% of odontogenic keratocysts may be associated with an unerupted tooth. Orthokeratinized odontogenic cysts have a slight male predilection, mostly affect individuals in their third decade, and predominantly affect the mandibular posterior area, similar to odontogenic keratocysts. Orthokeratinized odontogenic cysts are predominantly unilocular lesions, with 68% of these cysts associated with unerupted teeth in a dentigerous cyst-like fashion. Under the microscope, orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst shows quite a few differences from odontogenic keratocyst. The epithelial lining in the orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst is orthokeratinized stratified squamous and has onion skin-like luminal keratinization. This is in contrast to odontogenic keratocyst, which has a parakeratinized lining. Also, orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst has a granular layer with prominent keratohyaline granules and cuboidal to flat basal cells with no nuclear palisading or reverse polarization. On the other hand, odontogenic keratocyst does not have a prominent granular layer and has cuboidal to columnar basal cells with nuclei oriented away from the basement membrane. Orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst is not an aggressive lesion and is usually treated conservatively by enucleation and curettage. The prognosis for this lesion is very good and has low recurrence rates of 2 to 4%. Orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst has not been reported to be associated with nevoid basal cell carcinoma syndrome or Gorlin syndrome.